Bill's grandson. Now, when I was asked to say something today, my first thought was naturally to wonder what I was going to say. However, I quickly realized as I thought about Grandpa that my issue would not be what to say, but rather how in the world I was going to keep this shorter than a Fritcher goodbye. And for those of you that don't get that reference, let's just say we need concessions and intermission if I were going to speak that long. So I'll keep it shorter than that, I promise. You know, Grandpa always liked to tell a story about when he first got a cell phone, and he could never figure out the darn thing. But one time, he was driving down the road, and Grandma called him, and he actually managed to answer. And she was calling because she wanted to let him know that the news was reporting that there was a car going the wrong way, and she wanted him to be careful. To which his response was, "Margaret, there's not one going the wrong way. They're all going the wrong way." There it is. Now, this joke is just an example of the laughter that Grandpa brought to all of us. And it really goes with the first word that I think about when I think of Grandpa Bill, and that's joy. But it wasn't just that laughter, that humor, that prankster mentality that he had that we all knew and loved. Grandpa had the joy of the Lord in his heart. And that joy was infectious to anyone who spent any amount of time around him, and you couldn't help but feel it as well. It's what made you want to be around him all of the time. Whether you knew him for his whole life, for your whole life, or, in the case of my own son Landon, who at just 2 years old, had to be taken out of Hannah and Kendall's wedding because, once he saw Papa Bill, he wasn't going to stop crying unless he got to sit by him. See, it didn't matter how old you were or how long you knew him. You just knew that he had a joy about life that you wanted to be around all of the time. The other day, someone made me aware of a scripture that Grandpa had written on one of his clipboards, and it was Acts 20:24. "However, I consider my life worth nothing to me. My only aim is to finish the race and complete the task the Lord Jesus has given me, the task of testifying to the good news of God's grace." And I think that fits perfectly with the second word I think about when I think of Grandpa, and that's gratitude. You see, one common comfort I believe we all have here today is knowing that the moment Grandpa took his last breath in this world, he took his first breath in heaven. Now, Grandpa lived a great life and did many great things, but that's not why we have that assurance of knowing where he is right now. We have that assurance because we know that Grandpa believed in a risen Savior who made a way for us that we can't make ourselves. And Grandpa lived his life as one big thank you to God for what he did for us. You see, Grandpa understood that there's no amount of money you can make, no job you can do well enough, no building you can build tall enough, no picture you can paint perfectly enough, and no amount of deeds that you can do well enough to give us our own hope of getting into heaven. He knew that all we can do is believe in the hope provided for us by Jesus and what Jesus did for us, and then live our lives in a way that shows that gratitude each and every day. And not only did Grandpa understand this, but he lived out that gratitude as well as anyone I've ever known. The last word that comes to mind when I think about Grandpa Bill is love. No jokes here, no scriptures, no funny stories. For that, all you have to do is think about all the people in this room today, or 4 straight hours of people lined up outside that door over the course of last night. And the reason there's so much of an outpouring of respect for him and the life he lived is because he lived it with love. You see, the Bible tells us that no matter what else we are able to do, if we don't love, we are nothing. Well, if that's the case, then Grandpa was everything. A father, a friend, a grandpa and great-grandpa. He was a fast-pitch softball stud, a bus driver, a mentor, a servant leader, a soldier, a fishing buddy, a prankster, a hugger, a Cardinal fan, a son, a brother, fan of Hallmark Christmas movies. He was a true member and lover of his community, and he was the husband and life partner of his very best friend. And he was a true man of God. And in our eyes, he was the very best of all these things because he did them with a spirit and a heart of love. Fritcher could buy. But you know, as I was thinking about Grandpa, I also had a revelation. And that is that Fritcher goodbyes maybe really aren't all that bad. I mean, if you really think about what they are, okay, they're a chance for one more joke to be told, one more story to be shared, one more piece of advice to be given, one more hug to embrace in, and one more I love you to say. In these last few years, even until his very last day, I believe Grandpa knew exactly what he was doing, exactly what he was living for, and exactly what he was hanging on for. And I know this because even on his last day here on Earth, he still had one more joke to tell, he still had one more short story to share, he had one more piece of advice to give, one more hand to hold, one more hug to embrace him, and with his last words to Grandma, one more I love you to say. And I don't know about you, but that's one heck of a goodbye after one heck of a life well lived. Now, when I told people why I had to come to Illinois, a couple people said it must stink losing your grandpa around the holidays. But I can't think of a better gift and greater gift than knowing exactly where he is right now. Now, I know that heaven can't be any more perfect because of any one of us getting in there. But I'd be lying if I said I wasn't just a little more excited about getting there now and being able to see Grandpa one more time. However, until that time comes, I want to make sure I do my best to live a life of joy, of gratitude, and of love, because that's the example Grandpa Bill set for me and for all of us. And it's the person I know I want to be until the day we don't ever have to say goodbye again. So, Grandpa, from all of us,